So I use Vim and I use it for everything. I use it in the large code bases at Netflix and for all the stupid things I program on stream. So why do I use it? Obviously, in 2022, there is just so many editors I could be using, right? VS Code is insanely popular. IntelliJ is insanely powerful. Atom is still funny when people actually use it. Sublime apparently is making a comeback. So why would I use Vim in 2022? Obviously, people have very strong feelings about it. This guy on Twitter had very strong feelings about it. And of course, people on Twitch are baffled at this fact. Stop. So I want to break this question up into two parts. Why do I use Vim Motions and why do I use Vim? I think they can be answered a bit differently. So first, why do I use Vim Motions? Well, it started about 10 years ago when I decided that I was pressing Control Shift and the carrots, and I was so fast at just moving all around and highlighting and all that. And one of my friends said, you know what? You'd actually probably be pretty good at Vim. Now, my first Vim experience, of course, actually, unironically, involved me powering down the computer because I had no idea how to get out of it. That is not a joke. I am a meme. So when he told me that I should use Vim, I was pretty skeptical, honestly. Like, I didn't think I was gonna like it at all. So I was like, all right, how about we both do it for a week? And he agreed, let's do it for a week. So I installed the IDEA Vim plugin for IntelliJ because I figured, okay, that was what Vim was. I didn't even realize, you know. Anyways, I used that for about a week, and about the end of the week, I could tell, oh, I'm gonna be way faster than I was with the control and the shift and the key and the arrows and right? Like, I'm gonna be way faster. This is awesome. At that point, I didn't even know half of the Vim motions available. I was already feeling really, really good. And so for me, I think using Vim motions, I think anyone should do that, right? If you're editing a lot of code, it just makes sense to be able to edit it in the most efficient manner possible. I know people are like, well, most of the time I spend thinking. Well, I mean, there are times I spend thinking, and this is very, very true. There are times where I'm just like debugging or thinking or navigating and just like looking at stuff, and efficiency doesn't matter. But there's also plenty of times that I'm just building. I know what I wanna build. I have an idea in my head. I have a pathway, and it just involves me writing a ton of code out. And so yes, Vim motions really do speed up that process. But why use Vim in 2022? Well, first off, you get hired more. But second, I think it's best to kind of tell you a little bit of a story. When I was younger, 2016, I was bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. I only had two kids at that time. I remember going to my coworker's desk, Anders, and asking him a question about like, hey, this thing in Netflix, I'm not really sure what's going on. And he proceeded to open up Emacs, which of course I immediately laughed at him for. But then he just moved so fast. He was jumping. He was bobbing in and out of the files. And I was massively impressed. And I thought, holy cow, I have to learn this skill. And at the exact same time, a friend of mine who does stream on Twitch, some coding guy, you may have seen him, he also was using Vim and he was navigating and we were kind of exploring some parts of the JavaScript engine. And I was just like, oh my goodness, I don't have this superpower. Like, I am terrible at navigation. Like, when I use a computer, I'm in there, it's slow, I'm clicking around with my mouse, and I just remember feeling I'm missing this entire world, right? I've always just thought, oh, only like old weirdos use Vim, you know, all the cool kids use IntelliJ. I like IntelliJ. Okay, I don't like VS Code. I'm just never gonna like VS Code. You know, that's what I thought. And finally, a coworker, Yunong, came to me and just said, hey, yo, I'm gonna set you up and I'm gonna help you kind of get started with Vim because I think you're really gonna like it. And really, that's what the real G's use. So I was like, oh yeah, okay, I'm ready. I'm ready now. I've seen what people can do. I know I do not possess this power of fast navigation, really just being where you want at the speed of thought. And man, that first month, I was slower. I didn't like it. Things felt, you know, foreign. Like, I just didn't quite recognize where I was at, but it did not take long before there's no way I could go back to IntelliJ. There's no way I could use anything else. Of course, at that point, I got a little bit curious. I went and jumped into Doom Max and Space Max. And I also did Space Vim and Neo Vim and did all this. And eventually, it landed back on Vim. And I used that for years and I loved it. And it's the reason why I use Vim still to this day. Except for now, I have switched back to Neo Vim. I do think Neo Vim is the best. And I'll explain why in just one second. But ultimately, using Vim in 2022, it has allowed me to customize and build something exactly the way I want it. Being able to do exactly what I want to do at incredible speeds. I don't have to think anymore. I don't have to use my mouse. I don't have a lot of searching fatigue where I'm looking for the thing. I just do exactly what I want when I want to. And for me, that's super important during development. Last little note, why I use NeoVim, of course, more specifically. It has Tree Sitter, which allows me to have an AST write my editor so I can do things right there. It has a built-in LSP client. Very good, very fast, very swift. And lastly, and most bestestly, it uses Lua as its language for embedding and being able to write plugins. And Lua is a great language, right? Like VimScript is, you know, it's a bespoke language for a bespoke editor. And Lua is used in a bunch of places and it's well supported and there's lots of great documentations and it has nothing that's super confusing. So it's like fantastic to have and I absolutely love it. If you're someone who uses VS Code and you ever, you know, you're curious about using Vim, I do think it is a journey you should at least embark on. Understand what's on the other side. Get fast, really understand these things. And ultimately, I think you'll become a better engineer for it. Because there's something that happens when you use Vim, you'll end up relying more on the command line. And you'll find yourself, you know, oh, I should learn how to use these really cool tools, these core utils. If you can learn how to use core utils, you will save so much time. I cannot tell you how many times a day I use little things to process logs, be able to strip out values, add things together, grep, replace, all that stuff. It's just shocking how good those tools really are. Why are you still here? And why? How many of my videos are you going to watch before you hit that subscribe button? Disgusting. So do it right now.